हेलो फ्रेंड्स, लीगल ब्रीज वेलकम्स यू ऑल फॉर टुडेज डिस्कशन। टुडे वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट सर्टन चैलेंजेस अराइजिंग आउट ऑफ द इम्प्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ आधार, पर्टिकुलरली आफ्टर द पुट्टस्वामी केस। सो यू कैन टाइटल दिस एज इम्प्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ आधार इन द पोस्ट पुट्टस्वामी एरा, सर्टन चैलेंजेस। Before we go into the problems faced by various entities in the process of implementation of Aadhaar and the consequences thereafter faced by common people, particularly the poor and downtrodden, I believe it is my bounden duty to explain you the background in which the Aadhaar scheme, later on the Aadhaar Act, has been passed and its constitutional implications arising out of right to life, right to dignity, right to privacy, right to freedom of expression. It touches whole gamut of constitutional rights. In fact, some people used to call it, by implementing Aadhaar, the government of India has made an attempt to sell the constitutional rights in the wholesale as well as retail manner. There may be some truth in it, but however, there are certain advantages as well as disadvantages arising out of Aadhaar that has been carefully evaluated by the Supreme Court, and Honorable Supreme Court has delivered its verdict. It is constitutionally valid. But let us go back to its history. The UPA government, particularly in its phase one, I started thinking about this Aadhaar. They have established a committee under the chairmanship of Sri Nandan Nilekani for studying the technical feasibility of Aadhaar. Later on, many committees have been constituted for various purposes. Since it cannot be put under one ministry, this task has been assigned to the Planning Commission. The various standing committees pertaining to finance have also made a study about all these things. They come to a conclusion, by implementing Aadhaar, lot of leakage to the subsidy based programs can be stopped. Thereby government can save certain crores of rupees. So thereafter they started working on that. And high-level committees pertaining to the at cabinet-level committees have also been constituted. But please remember, Aadhaar UDIA, that is something called Unique Identification Authority, has also been constituted as a nodal agency for implementing this Aadhaar. All these things have been done without even enacting a single piece of legislation. Very unfortunate. And I'm afraid whether it comes exactly within the domain of the central government. In the name of establishing ID, it has encroached into various state subjects. However, this angle has not been addressed, to the best of my knowledge, by the scholars or the courts in this country. Since they focused on the surveillance, all these things, okay, you can refer that case later on. But without any piece of legislation, first they said Aadhaar will be used only for using the PDS, identifying the PDS beneficiary, or to see that the PDS benefits reaches only the targeted beneficiary system, targeted beneficiaries. That is how it has been started. Later on, it has been mandated to be linked with the bank accounts, even telephone connections, mobile connections, even for prepaid. Later on, it has been mandated to link with the income tax PAN account. For everything, Aadhaar has been mandated. Supreme Court has given interim orders in many cases. We should be thankful to Justice Puttasamy and some other public-spirited citizens and NGOs. they have battled consistently against the government of India, against this invasive or pervasive violator of privacy, threat to the privacy mechanism. They fought tirelessly, but however, they couldn't prevail over the government on the implementation of the Aadhaar is concerned. However, they have made a considerable success in convincing the Supreme Court that the right to privacy is part and parcel of fundamental rights under our constitution, and that right to privacy is being violated by this Aadhaar. But Supreme Court said, though Aadhaar intrudes into the privacy, but they said it's a proportional, its intrusion is justifiable on the proportionate ground that in the interest of the public. In 2016, the act has been enacted, mandating linking of all these things. And Supreme Court again in 2018 has given a verdict upholding the constitutional validity of the implementation of Aadhaar. Many presentations have been made before the Supreme Court, convincing the Supreme Court there is no error at all. If at all there are certain errors, it will be rectified in the due course of time. Based on that, the Supreme Court has delivered its verdict. Again, the review petition has also been filed. The judgment was also been delivered in the year 2021 with only one dissenting judgment, thanks to Justice Chandrachud, who has made a caution note and who is spearheaded in establishing the right to privacy of the citizens in this particular Puttasamy cases is concerned. But he dissented on the ground that since there is a case pending on the constitutional validity, the manner in which the Aadhaar Act has been passed by the Parliament, because Aadhaar Act has been passed as part and parcel of Finance Act, thereby depriving the powers of the Rajya Sabha. So that petition is still pending. Now, what is the problem? Because I have told you that the technocrats, particularly the government people, the UDIA chief, has convinced that Aadhaar is almost technical free. If at all there are certain technical glitches, that will be rectified in the due course of time. Based on that only, this judgment has been delivered. I am afraid that promise is a misleading promise, because all science is only probability and nothing possibility. One cannot rely upon 100%. And government is mandating solely only one identity proof, that is Aadhaar. That's a problem. Government should give space to alternate proof other than Aadhaar also, because every rule should have an exception. That principle has not been followed. There are a lot of starvation deaths have taken place in Jharkhand. That's a shocking fact, because they couldn't successfully establish their Aadhaar-based biometric ID at the PDS shops. Thereby, they have been erroneously denied their right to food. Thereby, their right to life have also been denied. It is not only in the state of Jharkhand. It has been proven elsewhere, like states of Rajasthan and other states, that because of the insistence of the Aadhaar by the government, many beneficiaries belonging to NRGA, the National Rural Guarantee Employment Program beneficiaries, couldn't get their money credited or couldn't withdraw their money from the accounts. There are many problems into that. So at least I hope one more time the Supreme Court should reconsider, and government should also reconsider. We don't oppose Aadhaar because Aadhaar has been done. So now there is nothing, it will be futile if you go back from that. But at least some alternate or exception shall be granted in case if the Aadhaar is not working out. Thereby the right to life a very valuable fundamental right conferred by our constitution is restored and not denied, and that shall be enjoyed by our citizens without hindrance on the technical ground of Aadhaar. We hope good sense will prevail over sooner rather than later. God bless you all. Thank you. Jai Hind.